Botswana. Most people don't know that Botswana, that Britain is in charge of Botswana completely. Botswana, as you are looking at it, that's why I keep telling Africans, know your continent. They teach Africans European histories, American history. I have no problem about that. But you have to know the history of the continent, the history of your place, whom you are. If you don't know it, somebody else will give you a different identity. And that is exactly what happened to Nigeria. To the people in that contraption called Nigeria, they had identity before. There is a name they know them with. I cannot say what I have not done. So I know what is going on there. Botswana has the richest. They are one of the countries that produces the best or the finest diamond. The resources of Botswana is more than the citizens of that country. On a ratio basis, if they could share the resources of Botswana, it is $10 million per person. $10 million per one Botswanan citizen on a ratio basis. 10 to 1, 10 million to one citizen. If they should share the resources, I am just minimizing it because not only diamond, they produce so many other things. But Botswana, as I can tell you, is just like a mini heaven because in Botswana, there is not much crime because everything is in order. I'm not promoting them. I'm telling us what I saw. Police station is a place where police people go there and send flowers to their loved ones. And sometimes they sleep. If there is crime, you know that they infiltrated and are importing crime to Botswana. Botswana is one of the most peaceful places in Africa. And it's a tourist site as well. The head of armed forces of Britain to Nigeria, to the contraption called Nigeria. What did they come to do? They came there to strategize and to give them anytime there is a place where there is contention, they will put their specialist there. And that Katrina Land is one of the specialists. They have many of them. They are trained, they are specialists. They don't have that kind of emotional that you think about. It's a woman. She understands about how women feel. Wasn't she there when they were raping a lot of women in the north and in the eastern part of that zoo? territory, the region called Biafra? Wasn't she around when they butchered so many women? Wasn't she there when, wasn't she the person sponsoring all these acts? Police brutality, killings and harvesting of the organs. Don't you know who, you don't know whom that person is? Okay, but if I want to talk to British government for a while. If you are so much in love of Africa, if you are so much in love of Africa, gave birth to a black child, because I call that boy a black child. If you look at that lovely boy, you wouldn't see the blackness or whatever that stain in him. But if you go to the blood, the blood makeup, you will see it, the body formation and what makes a white, Caucasian white, what makes black. Anything listed in color separation in color language. Anything that is not white is black. Do you know that Chinese are black? Asians are black. Anything that is not white is black. For those of us that doesn't even know, but I just want to ask them, if you so much love Africa, you love the interaction, you into their history, and as a result of that, he must be called anything or even be killed. And the young man fled. Oh, yeah, like, if you so much love Africa, if you so much love black people, why did you treat that fellow that way? I am addressing to Nigerians about the impending danger that is going to face them. Why? If that is the case, and they are so much in love with Africa, why is Zimbabwe the way Zimbabwe looks like? Why did Robert Mugabe, why did he disengage from British support? Said that support, that system is evil. He called it evil before he died. I know the man very well. Why did he call that system evil? They want your development. They want the best out of you. Do you think that they will maintain that you should be in the same union? That you should remain there, that that union, the collectivity of that union is so strong? You think they will be telling you guys should think properly? Why ask them a very simple question? Why, if that is the case, why wouldn't British government remain with EU and not get themselves out of EU and move out of European Union? Why did they move out of European Union? They move out of European Union because, from what I heard them saying, they were not in control of their destiny. They were not in control of their sovereignty. They were not in control of their judiciary. They were not in control of anything that happens in their country. It is being decided from Brussels. As a result of that, a man who is called Mr. Nigel Farage campaigned this viciously for many years and eventually convinced the British people, the greater population, that being with European Union would be Farage was not being punted down. Nigel Farage was being supported. Take It or Leave It was supported, and eventually referendum was conducted, and the larger population, the greater population, voted out of EU, and they left. As I speak to you, United Kingdom is a sovereign state from EU. EU does not decide what they do. They voted out. Even they try to come back to be part of the custom union so that goods and services can be moving around. And even free movement was even tampered with. You don't have free movement anymore. Before then, you can move around. But at the moment, it is not like that anymore. You have to go and do some certain logistics and planning and engagement, and before you can take off. It's not free movement anymore. And they are okay with that for their sovereignty. They are okay with that. For those of you tweeting, I saw something, I don't know if Osibanjo tweeted that when Nigeria breaks up, you need visa to move around. United Kingdom is experiencing it as well. They don't care. They say, we need visa. Control of your destiny is okay. Why are you denying that to the people of Nigeria? Why are you denying that to them? If that is the case, why are you denying that the people, the three component regions that made up Nigeria, the Arewa, the Oduduwa, and the Biafra, it was union. It wasn't a country. Nigeria. It's a weapon. The weapon that they will use to kill anyone that said no to them. But European Union didn't give any arms to anybody when Nigel Farage was seeking for referendum. Get this message very straight and clear. It is a very simple message. I am speaking to Nigerian intelligence service. If you do have one, pay attention and listen to me. Before you trigger something that will kill all of you, consume all of you, listen very carefully. Nigeria is never a country. What you are fighting to defend is never a country. That thing is a union. And in union, if you want to get into a union, you must go through agreement. And that is agreement that they signed to put together. In other words, you can call it treaty. Europe, the terrorism that you are scared of, the terrorism that you don't want to hear about, will be conducted in your territories and in your zones, anywhere you may be, any country that participated in that. Remember, I repeat, Nigerians are everywhere. I want to use the word Nigeria. Nigerians are everywhere. And if you don't want to let it go, that you want to forcefully keep them together, and the Fulanis are killing the Hausas. The Fulanis are killing the Middle Beltans, which fell under the region of Bia, because it was divided as Wazobia. The original slogan for Nigeria is Wazobia. What is Yoruba? That is come. So in Hausa is come. Bia in Biafra is come. So is Wabia. So where is that Wabia today? Because they don't mention it. They don't want to mention it. If you look into the behavioral attitude of the people living there, the middle Bertans, the people you call middle Bertans and Biafrans have similarities. They respect human rights and they respect human lives. Middle Bertans will not just go and start wanting to dominate you, to kill you for no reason. They were deceived in that war that Govan conducted, convinced them to go for war by the British. They were deceived. Let me use the word deceived. They were told that Igbos are your problem. And Ahmadu Bello said it 12 days after the so-called flag independence. And he told them that Igbos are domineering. Igbos want to take over your territories. Igbos are very, very in control of whatever. So if you let Igbos be, you will be vanished. Today, who are the ones killing the middle Bertans? Are the Igbos killing them? Are the Igbos killing the middle Bertans? Not at all. The only thing that Biafrans can do, that is the Igbos, is to go and develop your regions. To go and where they are very entrepreneurial kind of people, very innovative and very inventive. Is God giving gifts or talents? So the Biafrans go everywhere, school everywhere, marry whomever they want to marry. They don't discriminate. Biafrans marry Europeans very much. And the Arikwas. Arikwa doesn't marry. You have shown me one Fulani man that married Oyibo. Show me, I will tell you his history. Why he's there? It is just like one out of 1 million. But Biafrans are everywhere. Oduduwas, they go around. They marry anybody they want to marry. They are very creative people, very innovative people. But one thing is certain. Have lasted for 100 years. They tried. Now the 100 years has expired. And so many people are now agitating. The Oduduwas are agitating. Biafrans are agitating. Arewas wants to go. And Middle Belt as well wants to go. Whichever side they want to fall into, they can be. I have assured the Middle Beltans that Biafrans will never step into your territory to dominate you, to go against you, to take over your region. It is never going to happen. I told them that. I spoke to them. I'm not going to mention names. That is not going to happen. Under this command that our leader Mazin Nandanu is giving us, it's not going to happen. We never invaded anybody. Go back to your history. Even those of us, those of our brothers in the River Rhine, wherein they lied against, they lied to them that Igbos are your problem. And all of a sudden, they began to hate their brothers. That to the present day, a governor in River State, who is an Ikwere man, Igbo man, said that he's not Igbo and invited the military to kill his people, denied his lineage. What we are doing, I want anyone listening to me to listen very carefully. What we are doing today is what they called in Igbo language, Oguejiofo. Or anyone who can interpret this thing to them, let the person do that. Oguejiofo. If you fight with a just cause, you know you have nothing to lose. I have nothing to be afraid of. You are justified in your quest to get your freedom and to fight for your liberation. You are justified. Now, if Britain can go to that level, can give sovereignty, can say they want sovereignty. They want to be out of European Union. They want to be out and be to control their justice system, control their military, control everything, their law and order. And they did it. And when Scotland asked for it, they gave Scotland ability to go and conduct referendum. They didn't kill Nicola Sturgeon. They did not kill any one of them. They supported them because it's in their constitution to do that. Why is it that Britain they don't want it. It's against what they stand for. They prefer to see you in your hut going naked. They prefer to see you dancing with leaves on your waist. And it tickles them. It tickles their supremacy. It tickles their mindset that they are way advanced of ahead of these people. That's what they're doing. So now, if you ever think that this particular thing we are doing today, saying today, is just about the Biafran, you are a joker. You don't understand what is happening. And let me tell this thing to most of the people listening. When you refuse, when you go against this, saying, we will come down there and strengthen the armed forces. We will come down there and provide logistics so that they can keep the union, the unholy union and wicked union together. I want to show you something that you are not seeing. The people that you destroyed their parents in the 60s, even this killing started 1945 from the history. And you came all out, full-blown war, 67 to 70. Those kids that survived are the ones that are dealing with today. And some of us have advanced. Some of us have skills and technology. And you think you are looking at those people down there thinking that you can do anything and get away with it. I am telling you, I'm assuring you that this will bring devastation and destruction to your nation and other nations that are involved in this. I am very much aware that Shell is there too. Shell is in this dirty business. Shell is there. Shell is very much in this dirty business. And they are there letting the British to lead the way by they are doing the killings, sponsoring terrorism, giving Fulanese arms, giving them the logistics on how to kill people, sending people, as I speak, they are sending multitude of people to Benue State to mix up with the people. And Benue State, listen very carefully. If you let your governor go down, your state will be taken and will be taken for life. If you let that man go there, they attempted assassination. They have killed other people. Once they succeed, they will put a stooge there, just like Ozodimba of Imo State. And that person will be doing the bid of the Fulanese and the British, killing their people. But I am assuring all these men, hand join hand together, you will never go unpunished. Because you are a wicked man. You will never go unpunished. You will be punished. All your activities will be brought to book. Not like the zoo own saying, you will be brought to book and nothing happens. You will be dealt with seriously and heavily. It will affect you, your children, to the generation wherever they may be scattered. They will be hunted down. Even the one in Anambra State who brought Navy. I've never seen in any history where Navy comes mainland. Navies are known to be in the marine, in the sea, where fire air, and why the military will mount the ground floor, the ground level, but they will be in their barracks to and you know, be waiting on standby just in case of any invaders. While police service, not force, should be, you know, around everywhere to monitor what is happening, to make sure that people are safe, to make sure that no lives are lost. That is how any normal country is run, not the other way around. You created police, you created SARS, you created the Navy, and the Navy will come to the mainland, and they are fully armed, and they will be killing people, they will be abducting people, and you are sitting in your governor's office and be saying that all is well. I want to tell you this. The will of the people will prevail. I have never seen where darkness overtook the light. I have never seen where evil defeated the good. I've never seen. Even the psalmist says, since I was young and now I am old. David wrote that in the book of Psalms. He said, I have not seen the righteous forsaken, nor the children of the righteous begging bread. He said it before he passed. And we are quoting it every now and then. Even if you look in the book of Matthew chapter 11, verse 12, he says it's the death of John the Baptist. Master was quoting it when he was moderating, that the kingdom of God suffers violence and the violent take it by force. You have to forcefully take your kingdom. When that happens, that is where when British we call other international communities, telling them these people are terrorists. You will see what looks like what is worse than Bin Laden's activities. You will see it in your streets. You will see it in your zones, in your territories. Because when God was speaking to Moses, he said the frogs, the plague. He said, you will see it in your kitchens, in your kneading bowls, in your bedrooms. They will be there. This is one of the terrors Elohim used to teach Pharaoh great lessons. A nation that is mad, radical nation, we at a time begin to plan preemptive attack to nuke you, to get you nuked. If you go further, dear France will not do it. And the other nation that are mad looking at you will do it. You will be nuked. I pray that time I will be out of where I am. In Europe, all use this. You to a halt. Blackout can destroy your infrastructures. There are many things Elohim have in stock that is not speaking out, but he's telling his prophet to warn all of you that danger is pending. Danger is pending. If you don't back up from that place, if you don't back up from that region you call Nigeria, you gave a name, and destroy other the original names of the people, remove them from the map. That is crime against humanity. You don't go to people's home and remove their names. Mugabe spoke and they got him killed. The president of Tanzania spoke. They got him killed. And they said, we have monopoly over death. We can kill anybody we want to kill. But you remain unkillable. Is that so? Now I have to tell you this. Tread very carefully. The people you came to, the head of the armed forces, whatever may be your name, hippie or shippie, I want to tell you this. Tread very carefully. Your arrogance is overwhelming. You can't be taller than somebody at the same time you are shorter than the person. It's not possible. If you do me what a tall person can do, I will do you what a short man can do. It's a saying. I want you to pay attention. You are not dealing with the people you dealt with in 67 and 70. You are not dealing with them. You are dealing with a different gene, a different people that are wired differently to do some certain things that you cannot be able to fathom that they can achieve it. It's achievable. I want to tell you this additional. Sometime early this year, our leader, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, unveiled battalions or legions of men. And you saw the legion, he called them Eastern Security Network. And all of a sudden, he closed the channel. He tuned to another channel. And you people are very, you are so stupidified that you forget very easily and quickly. If you are intelligent enough, you will ask yourself a question. If those legions and other legions that are somewhere else are unleashed, I give you 7 days, you will flee from everywhere you are, from that contraption. You will definitely flee. You don't know where they are. Okay? If they are unleashed, you will be no more. You will be no more. So consider this. You always say, we have the military technology, we have this logistic, and blah, blah, blah. And inhale it and drop dead. I want to warn all of you to back off. I get them before, not beside, I get them now. You have done it before, yes, and you are flexing your muscles. We defeated you 67, we carried the war. We came to your place, we defeated you. You can't do it again. I can assure you, I'm assuring you that you can't do it again. I want to say this. I'm saying this. I pray that God will keep our leader.
You see?
I pray that Elohim will keep him. The only savior you people have is because Mazin Nnamdi Kanu is leading this movement. As many of you think, oh, let's get rid of him, everything will be okay. That is when you will see hell. You will, all of you that are going to Abuja, carrying placards, going to the embassy, bring him home. Let us kill him. Let us hang him. Bring him. He is causing a problem. I tell you, because a move was made. The man says, stop it. If not, wherever you may be in the northern part of the zoo, your heads will roll. Those in America, your heads will roll. Those even in United Kingdom, you will be affected, all of you. That battle will be fought internationally, and the world will carry it on the news. I'm assuring all of you. You think you can eat your cake and have it? You can't eat your cake and have it. The one that you're talking about, destitute, paid to do damages, thinking he can do it. How dare you? How dare you? I just pray. Sometimes I look at you people, I said, I can see some of the, you know, I don't want to make this alteration. I think something is wrong with black race. Something is basically wrong with some of us. Not all of us. There are those that have seen the light and are following it systematically. There are those that refuses to see the light out of their stupidity and short-sightedness. They don't want to see it. What is facing them? It's just like a racist. A racist will see a black scientist, and the scientist will be doing formidable things and inventing things and making things work. The racist white man will say, "Here, no, he's nobody. He's a black man. He's nobody." But he's a scientist. He's a black man. He's a scientist. You didn't wire him to be scientist. Elohim wired him to be scientist. And you, white person with white skin, thinking that, yeah, you are what you are because of the color of your skin. You are a fool. You are a compound fool. You don't know what you're talking about. Because some certain elements are not educated in Africa, and they are doing things in their own way. And you think, well, they are just like that. If you go to Zambia, you kill them. If you go to South Africa, I know what happened when Chris Hani at a time began to conduct operation single-handedly by himself. He was refusing the order from Dr. Nelson Mandela in prison. He thought, he looked at it critically. He said, no, I'm not going to let this thing happen anymore. He said, I believe you. I trust you. I love you, the Madiba. But I'm going to go for these people. I'm going to hit them hard. I began to hit them hard. Go to YouTube and find out. Go out what Zuma used to say when they provoked the former president of South Africa, Jacob Zuma. He would say, if you push me, I will tell you who killed Chris Hani. who masterminded his death. He has been saying it. Are you not paying attention to what he was saying? Our leader is there and doing his things. But there are other people that are mad, very radical. They are very mad. He's telling us, calm down, calm down, calm down. And some idiots are saying, let's go and kill him. Bring him. Let's. If Elohim, I pray Elohim wouldn't allow that to happen. But if you do, say let, and they touch him, everything in that contraption will flame up. Will flame up. And providing you intelligence on air, you are fools. Everything will flame. Death in numbers, you know. Or the killers will never be seen. Unknown soldiers will be released to do the destruction. Massive one, collateral damage. Those that are saying they are this, you are in foreign countries talking. Step down, step your foot down to Biafran land. Go down there. If you are really in control, go down there. Go and talk. Go down there and open your mouth and talk. Say, Nnamdi Kanu do this, Nnamdi Kanu did that. Nnamdi Kanu gave you life. Those of you talking, he gave you life, trained you. I remember when intelligence was provided. He still came on air and said, anybody that sees Shemefo should buy him a drink. Anybody that's Agidi in Yoruba language is called Eko. Eko is not solid. Eko is, you can even blow hot air, it will break into pieces. Complete Agidi man. And he's talking, the idiot has never been anywhere. His trip was from the zoo to United Kingdom until IPOB came and gave him lights. He started talking. Today he rose up and he's talking some elements. The one in America who happens to be a dealer. That guy shouldn't let me talk to him. The one talking, who happened, if I open my mouth, we go and apprehend that guy straight away. Because IPOB came, all of us came out and began to run under IPOB and started talking. But before, go and trace what you used to do before. Go and check what you are doing. Your track record will be questioned at a time. If you want to challenge foreign countries, they will also scrutinize you to look into your activities. If they see anything that we question you, they will call you to order. Which MFO began to talk. Onyibe, who used to answer Mazina and the kind of sir, yes sir, began to insult him. And you are telling, somebody is telling me not to talk about them. That's the, I'm talking of the activity, what they're doing, and the detriment, what that in the real effect of the activities. That's what I'm talking about. And so many people don't want this truth to be told them, and they don't want to know. They look at the person talking, say, yeah, he's nobody, because you are in your comfort zone. I will plead to step down to Biafran land. If you are ready, give me a call, we meet there. I keep telling our people, tread very carefully. Lower your MV missile. Lower your missile. Lower it and bring it down. And let this man do his job. Let him lead us and deliver our people. We are in a critical mess as we are talking right now. The person that they sent to Nigeria is a specialist who destroys Zimbabwe. The person that I am talking to you is talking about, the woman, is the one who put many problems in Southern Africa and